Hello, math class. Welcome back. This is Mr. Jacobs. Exercise number 10, find the x and y intercepts of the linear equation. So I want to recall, what is the x and y intercepts of a graph? So quickly, let's just look at our notes here. And here we go. So the x intercept is where the line intersects the x axis, and the y intercept is where the line intersects the y axis. How do you find the x-intercept mathematically? Down below in green, the x-intercept, to find it, let y equal 0, and then solve for x. And mathematically, to find the y-intercept, let x equal 0, and solve for y. So let's try that. So we're taking a look at number 10. So the x-intercept, let y equals 0, solve for x. All right, and so my equation is negative 6x plus 9y equals negative 18. Zero. So the value of the x-intercept is 3. As an ordered pair, it would be 3 comma 0. It's not asking you to write it as an ordered pair, but if you did, that's what it would be. The y-intercept at x equals 0, solve for y. Zero. So the value of the y-intercept is negative 2. And as an ordered pair, you would have, say that again. That's right. Alrighty. So again, I just follow the directions given in the textbook, and that's how you would do that, okay? Let's look at you could try number 12 on your own, okay? I don't want to work that one out for you. I think you can see that, you know, just to let you know, for those who are still trying to figure out the procedures, here you're going to let, for the x-intercept, let y be 0. For the y-intercept, you let x be 0. Substitute and solve for y here. And here you're going to solve for x. Okay? So I skipped 13. I didn't assign it. Number 14. Here's where things get kind of fun. Here now we're going to use this technique of finding the intercepts to graph the linear equation. Now, there's the method, let x be zero to find the y-intercept, and let y be zero to find the x-intercept. And mathematically, you can do that repeatedly over and over again. So if I was going to do that really quick, x-intercept would be so the ordered pair would be, that's my x-intercept, and I'll write it as x-int, okay? Then my y-intercept alright. So now, to graph this, take your big ideas. Big ideas, graph template, and interact with the graph. And I believe if you just take your mouse and click on the screen, it'll draw a point. And there's also a delete button if you draw it in the wrong spot. So interact with that and see how it works. Yeah, I see that up here. See where it says undo, redo, reset. Line. So the first point I'm going to draw is the x-intercept. We said that was 3, so find the value of 3 on the x-axis. That's this point here. And then the value 2 is the y-intercept, and that's here. And then, of course, big ideas will draw this out for you right away. There isn't really much you have to do. So here, I'll just draw it out here. There we go. It'll do that for you, okay? And then, of course, you want to write the ordered pairs. You want to write the ordered pairs below. So I'll write the coordinates for these points too as well. There you have it. So the x-intercepts would be 3, 0. The y-intercept was 0. Let's use gray. Color-coded everything. Okay, great question. So that's a great example for the next set of questions that you'll be working on, okay? The next set of questions that you'll be working on. So I think you can try number 16 on your own, and number 22 as well. Try that on your own, okay? I might come back to 22. I might come back to 22. So I am going to look at now at exercise 24, a word problem, and font is awful small, so I'm going to zoom in. I hope we're able to read it. But this is a word problem, and it says, you are ordering shirts for the math club at your school. Short sleeve. Hey, you woke up. You can go turn the TV on. Okay, I'll get you some cereal right now. Give me 10 minutes. You want to get a snack from the drawer, the bottom, and then I'll get you some cereal. Yes, my daughter woke up. It's 6:30 in the morning. She's early bird. She's 6 years old. So back to the question. You are ordering shirts for the math club at your school. Short sleeve shirts cost $10 each. Long sleeve shirts cost $12 each. You have a budget of $300. The equation 10x plus 12y equals 300 models the total cost, where x is the number of short-sleeved shirts and y is the number of long-sleeved shirts. All right, so that makes sense. So that's what it costs to purchase the shirts. And then when you sell them, you're probably going to sell them for more money to make a little profit, I think, right? Unless you're just wanting to break even and just give everybody a shirt at cost, since you're not a business. So it says graph the equation and the intercepts. So we can do that. So the equation is what is given to model the total cost of the shirts, right? So here's what we see. Or in terms of budget, right? So here's my equation. Just enlarge that a bit. So we want to graph the equation using the intercepts. And so we know that, I'll use orange this time, the x-intercepts, right? To find that, you let y equals 0, solve for x, okay? So let's do that. So I have the equation already written, so I'm just going to go with that. I'm going to go with that. I have the equation written up here. So I'm just going to substitute. Now, I'm not going to show like I was before, right? Highlighting and all that. I'm just going to write this down. Watch this. I'm going to write 10x plus 12 times y. See it? Equals 30. So hopefully you see that the y value is here. Initially, it's up here, right? Right, but I didn't have to rewrite that. I'm just hoping you can make that connection, right? We're kind of skipping some steps, keeping things quick. So we know this is 0, and 10x plus 0 is 10x, equals 30. Then when you divide by 10, you get 3. Hope you can see that. See what's going on? Right? So my x-intercept is 3. Oh, and by the way, I was looking at the x-axis here. It's the y-axis. And I was looking at the scale. Look, it goes 10, 20, 30. So I'm thinking, wow, 3 is awful small because I don't see the tick mark 3 here. So I was thinking, wow, that's weird. And I noticed a mistake. Look, here the equation says 300. Notice that? And I wrote 30. I forgot a 0. So it's important that when you write these things down, you know that you constantly look and check and see if what you're doing makes sense. And it didn't make sense for me because I forgot a 0. And that's how I knew, oh, something's wrong. So if I put a 0 here, make it 300, then this becomes 30. And that makes more sense for the x-intercept because I can see that value here. See it? See what's going on? And you know that's going to be 30 comma 0, okay? So that's my x-intercept, the first point. Now the y-intercept That's what we have. You let x be 0. Now 12 goes into, let's see, it's going to be 2. Is it 25? I think it is. Let me double check. Okay, 1 second. 300 divided by 12 is 25, yeah. So it's okay to use calculators for sure. Oh, and maybe I should just revisit that x equals 0. That's where it's 0 there, right? We knew it was up here. I was moving quickly and kind of pushed through without slowing down. That happens. But that's how I set up that y-intercept equation and substituted for 0. All right? So 25. So where's 25 on the graph? See that here, 20, 30, between that is 25. And we're gonna graph that. The Big Ideas Math online platform should connect the points for you. And there you, oops. It says to graph the equation. Now I'm not, here's the deal. I don't know what it's gonna draw. I don't know if it's gonna draw the segment because it should be a segment. Because there's no such thing as negative shirts, right? Or, negative shirts. So it should do that. It should draw a segment with endpoints, right? But I'm not sure. I don't know if it's going to draw a line or segments. You tell me what it does. Yeah, it's a segment. It says segment right here. See it? So it's going to draw a segment. Good. Glad we pointed that out. Think about why it's a segment, not a line, okay? Now, the x-intercept shows, this is the x-intercept here in orange, shows that you can buy how many short-sleeve shirts. Well, according to the directions here, the value of x is the number of short-sleeve shirts, and the value of y is the number of long sleeve shirts. So what I see here is x, the x value is 30, and the y value is 0. So 30 long sleeve, 0, or 30 short sleeves, and 0 long sleeves. So this would be 30 short sleeve shirts, 0 long sleeve shirts. So those x and y coordinates mean something. And then the y-intercept is 0 short sleeve, 25 long. So this would be 25. This would be 0 short sleeve. Make sense? It says 12 students decide that they want to 12 students decide they want short-sleeved shirts. How many long-sleeved shirts can you order? All right. So when you see this statement, 12 students want short-sleeved shirts, short-sleeved shirts represent the x variable. And so this would be x equals 12, right? And so now the question is, well, we know we have a $300 budget. How do we use the equation to figure out how many long sleeve shirts we can buy? So let's write the equation. The equation is 10x plus 12y equals 300. So the question is, how many long sleeve shirts can you order? That's, you're trying to find the value of what is y equal to. That's what you're trying to find, because y represents the long sleeve shirts. So you're solving for y when x equals 12. Does that make sense? So let's substitute. solving for y when x equals 12. So use the equation, substitute. All right. Now, how many times does 12 divide into 180? There's nothing wrong with using a calculator. 15. So when you have 12 short sleeve shirts, you can buy 15 long sleeve. So the answer is 15. Okay, 15 long sleeve shirts. Now I want to make a point about this. This 12, 15, that's actually a coordinate on the graph, 12, 15. Let's look at the graph and see what it looks like. See if that makes sense. And it kind of does. Look. If I look right here, I'll use a different color here. Let's use this icy blue. But this is 15 right here. See it? It's 15. And it looks like it's slightly past 10. Are you following? So that point does look like it's 12 short sleeve, 15 long sleeve. It would have to be on that line segment since the equation represents that line segment. Alrighty. So I'm going to leave that there for a second and give you a chance to write that down. About a minute or so. I know I wrote a lot quickly. Go ahead and write that down. The equation has practical value, right? Where the variables x and y represent shirts. The constant 300 represents our budget amount in dollars. And the equation is written in standard form. Remember, ax plus by equals c. A and b are the coefficients of x and y, and c is the constant. 26 lets you take a look at that and think about it, okay? See if you can find the error and answer those questions. 29, 30, and 31 and 32 are requiring you to identify the graph of the equation in standard form. So I will take a look at the first one, and you try the others on your own. Now, it looks like 29 and 30 are identical, except pay attention. Look, this says 5x plus 3y equals 30. 30 says 5x plus 3y equals negative 30. So watch out for that negative sign. Be careful. Changes the graph. So I'll write this down, and I'm going to show you something really cool. It's called the cover-up method, and let me write that down. And what it does is it allows you to solve for x and y very quickly. Watch. So when you let x be 0, you're finding the y-intercept, right? So watch this. This is the cover-up method. I'm going to grab a value here. I'm going to do this. I'm going to take this here. Pick the color white, and I'm going to cover up x. See what I just did? I covered up x. And it's like saying let x be 0. 3 times x is 3 times 0 is 0, so it's gone. And so now the technique is to take what's left and divide to solve for y. So you get y equals 10. See how fast that was? So that's my y-intercept. Pretty quick, right? And then you take what you just covered up, x. Are you following? And now you cover up y. That's the same as saying, hey, let y be 0, and 3 times 0 is 0. And I guess x was 5x, so it was 5 times 0. I think I misspoke. But here, now you divide by 5 to solve for x. And you get x equals 6. And that's the x-intercept. Are you following? So that is the cover-up method. You can cover up the x and y variable with your thumb, right? And so look at those values, 10 and 6. I think I see it right here. The scale here is by 2s, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. That's 10 for the y-intercept, right? And 6 is the x-intercept, 2, 4, 6, there it is. I think that's it. It's the y-int, x-intercept. That's the answer. So that's what's going on there, okay? Yes. Called the cover-up method. Otherwise, what you're going to be doing is you're going to be using these techniques here where you have to let y be 0, substitute, and solve, right? And here you let x be 0, substitute, and solve, okay? So that's a lot of work. Okay, I think that's a wrap. Thank you again for listening. Like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. And we will see you soon. Bye-bye, everyone. Enjoy your week.